HoloLens here. HoloLens is a fully contained holographic computer. There's no keyboard, there's no mouse, there's no cables, there's no desktop computer. There's nothing apart from you and the 3D world that you live in when you have it on your head. It's about that new type of computing, that new type of thinking. It's the first time we're creating this kind of deep learning exercise around these new computers anywhere in the world. We've got all the 24 of the brightest and best from the university here going to receive that sort of training.
Microsoft's goal is to empower every person and organization on the planet to achieve more. That's why we're here and supportive of everything that Pfizer are doing. They are on the front line of people who are going to be using 3D in a commercial environment, and that is going to be a very, very rich skill for decades to come.
We're working on, or working with rather, the Microsoft HoloLens, and we're given, you know, various companies have been assigned to, and we're trying to solve problems that, you know, they have that they think they can solve with this new technology.
It's a time of creation. Everything we do now could be the way it's done in the future.
Nobody else have used this technology before, and I feel like I am like pushing the boundaries in some way.
I already have an interest in VR and how it can be used in a load of different industries. So I thought, hey, why not increase my skill set and find out a bit more, and decided to sign up for it.
Well, it's just really exciting to be right at the forefront, right at the crest of the wave that is going to be mixed reality. It's a really important time to be involved in these kind of projects.
The difference between that and that, it's receiving energy both times.
We're meeting the company for the first time today, kind of learning more in depth about the requirements of the project.
Tuesday is our client engagement day, so today they're getting in touch with all the businesses that they're working in. It's an important key week. This is the first week where they've completed their training, and now they're beginning to work on the projects for real.
We're currently in talks with the company that we're working with, and from there we'll be starting to do regular scrum sessions where we meet in the morning, figure out what we need to do, what needs doing, what's been done.
It's a lot of bickering, discussion, you know, heads bang every now and then, but it, you know, it's all part of it really.
I'll get those animations to work properly, we'll just scrap them for now.
The reason why we have a big interest into this accelerator project was that here all the missing pieces are brought together.
This augmented reality, mixed reality and virtual reality is completely going to change the way training happens, change the things happens. And this is where LearningMed is really interested in.
It's just kind of a nice way for us to kind of get a prototype out there to show the business what can be done in augmented reality, and then spark some interest for them for investing in this in the future as well.
I am working on the Audi project. We are working together to create an interactive experience of creating an engine. We are now in the middle of it. We have finished like a first prototype of like showing how the experience will look, and we've defined the first look for our UI and our user experience.
Working on a true project with actual stakes with an actual company. It's just amazing to be able to use these techniques, working in teams. Just getting a piece of software made is an achievement.
So how I've been working with the team is I come here every Tuesday and we do kind of like a status update on what they've been doing for the previous week, and then also I get an idea of what they're going to be doing for the next week.
We showed our first demo 2 weeks ago and it didn't work at all.
Oh, that's embarrassing.
Completely humiliating in front of a member of Microsoft and in front of our partner from Adventure.
For the first 3-4 weeks, we didn't really know what we wanted out of this as such. And as we've gone along, we've gone back, looked at the model, said, okay, we need a bit more enhancement here. We need a bit more work done here. It's a mixture of the two, really. What does Centrica want and what can Pfizer and the students deliver?
I think she's much happier with us now, now that she's actually been able to see, oh, we started here. Here's milestone one, milestone two. And we're about to show her the minimum viable product, which I would argue isn't ready yet, but it looks ready, and that's all it needs to be to show somebody.
Every time I've come here and had a look at the demo, it gets better and better every week. So that's definitely progress there, which is exciting.
The best part has definitely been the teamwork.
So getting chucked in a team with people you don't know and then working with them and it working well.
We've had to build friendships. We've had our problems with each other, but all teams do. But in the end, we've become a team, and that's quite important.
It's a new experience creating a piece of software for the client. And it's been a bit of a learning cliff, to be honest. But it's been one that I definitely feel like at the end of the day, we've all taken a lot of important information from it.
Being able to talk face to face with quite high up Microsoft officials is, you know, you don't get to do that really. So having that sort of connection's a real big deal.
There's only going to be a couple of hundred people in the world who are great at building for the HoloLens, and being a part of this project and being a part of this whole process and building and getting on it this early, this is going to be something that very few, probably none of your peers have.
I've worked with an amazing team and I've made lifelong friends and I get a lot of industry experience.
It just builds those soft skills that that you don't generally train at a university. Leading teams, being part of a team, just working in a team, pitching your idea, accepting that maybe your idea isn't the best, and taking criticism.
After 9 weeks of hard work, finally we are here to showcase the demos. The solution that we have provided is really amazing. You should definitely have a look at it.
Today it's the first time we see the results of the accelerator project, and so when every part of the developed things are brought together.
I feel like it was definitely like an amazing experience. We've developed something that I haven't seen before and something that can be used in the future as a foundation for next new technologies. And I feel like that's very important for the future of technology.
We've made a really nice piece of software, and the entire experience in creating it has just been a really good learning experience for everyone involved.